So there's one important rule in any type of relationship, but especially in romantic relationships. He who needs the other one the most is always in the weakest position. And that's obviously a position you never want to be in. And we can communicate that weak or that strong position in a ton of different ways. But in this video in particular, I'll dive into how to let a man know you like him in a non-needy way, in a non-weak way. So if you are dating a guy, or if you are in the early stages of a relationship with a guy, but even if you simply want to flirt with a guy, then this will be a very important video. Because if you've read any of my books about relationships, dating and love, or listened to any of my podcasts on the website, then you know that neediness kills attraction like torrential rain would kill the sensitive flame of a tiny sweet little candle. It's that devastating. It's really bad when it comes to love, attraction, chemistry, and relationships. We cannot keep being attracted to a needy person. It's physically not possible. It kills the butterflies of love, or the hormones of love even. As humans, we are drawn and attracted to character traits like self-confidence, humor, sassiness, wit, and all of those are signs of strength. Not signs of weakness, not signs of neediness. So when they want to attract someone they have feelings for, a lot of people follow a very funny formula. It's their how to flirt formula, or their how to get someone to fall in love with me formula. And it's a rather strange one. It's a funny one. It goes a little bit like this. If I tell you I like you, then you will like me back, right? That's what the formula says. So in other words, if I tell you I think you are attractive, then you will be attracted to me. Of course, that's what the formula says. If I tell you I'm falling for you, then you will fall for me, evidently. Well, it is a very effective formula for having tumbleweeds blowing through your love life. In other words, for not having one, because it doesn't work. Now, men will use this bad love formula by giving compliments. So a guy can say, I really like your eyes, while he may be staring at your breasts instead, of course. Or he may say, you're really, really beautiful, you're really attractive, while he still is staring at your breasts. Of course, some men do this. Now, mind you, men are not the only champions in misusing this love formula. Women do this as well. They suffer less from the staring part, obviously, but they may, for instance, say, I've been thinking a lot about you lately. Or a woman can say, or even text, I've been thinking a lot about our last date. I can't stop thinking about our last date. She can even say something simple like, I think you're very attractive. And then she wonders why it doesn't work. Well, it's because why and when it is used. There is a right time to use this type of formula, but it's never in the beginning of a relationship, let alone when you haven't even begun dating each other. So we're simply not going to use it, given that it's a sign of weakness, especially when used in the early stages of a relationship. Now, when women use any of those sentences, they mean well. They want to make him feel special, but that's exactly the reason why this here backfires. He won't feel special. If you use any of these sentences early on, so before you went out on a date with him, or when you've only been dating for a couple of weeks, then he didn't have to earn it. So consequently, he will believe that you say this kind of thing to a lot of guys, possibly even to every guy you meet. Even when that's not the case, his mind will generalize. If it seems easy to get, it has no value. So he will think that, or he will think that the woman who uses this is needy, that she's trying to get something from him by telling him that he's attractive. That's even worse. Some men run for the hills for a whole lot less, like tiny little spiders or an angry-looking pigeon that flies above. Men scare easily, and I talk from experience. I used to have anxiety and panic attacks in the past, so you have to be careful with men. There are much, much better ways to make him feel special. There's a much better way to flirt with a guy, to make him fall in love with you if that's what you are after. You can make him feel special by letting him earn your attention. Don't make it too easy. Do you remember how it was done in the actual time of princes and princesses, when they were still walking around in the wild? A lady would be walking around and she would totally not accidentally drop something while walking past someone she was interested in, someone she liked. Now the guy then, especially if he liked her, if he was interested in her, he would pick it up, run after her and say, my lady, you dropped something. And then she goes, oh, did I? And then the conversation starts. This is what she wanted altogether from the get-go. Now he's putting in an effort here from the beginning. If you want your guy to treat you like a queen, you have to act like one from the start. That's how it works. Now this here, by the way, making him earn it, is the way that she proves that she likes him. Had she directly started a conversation with this guy here, it wouldn't have had the same effect on his feelings. This here gave him feelings. Picking it up, putting in an effort is what gave him feelings. And make no mistake, attraction and the butterflies are all about feelings. That's exactly why the bad how to flirt formula I gave you earlier on is used so often. The women that use it want to give him great feelings. That's what they want, but they are trying too hard. They are putting in too much of an effort. Now this video here is not about flirting, I discuss that elsewhere, but my point is that you can show him that you like him without being needy and while still being feminine. Feminine being the key word here. Men are supposed to do the chasing, not women, and you are of course free to think, well hey, these are not the 50s anymore, women can do the chasing just as well. Of course they can, but it goes against the natural laws of attraction. And just like gravity, when we do something that's against the natural laws, then everything starts working against us, and that's not what we want. So instead of using the bad, how to make him fall in love formula, there's a much better way to show him that you like him, and that's by using what I call hints of challenge. Not hints of neediness, not hints of weak behavior, by the way, hints of challenge. Not hints of emotional baggage either, because that scares men even more than an angry pigeon or two, so you've got to be careful with this. Great men love a challenge. So let me give you a couple of examples. Say that you are in a conversation with a guy, in real life or online, and you respond to something he said by saying, well, I'm not sure that's a good idea because I wouldn't want you to get a crush on me. I wouldn't want you to get a crush on me. You say this with a smile, and if you said this online, then you add a smiley face behind it. Now this has now moved the conversation into new territory, to another level, but you're not on your knees. You're not weak. This is not needy. What you have done is created a challenge. You have created chemistry. That's what you need. And every prince likes and needs a challenge. Now there's a little bit of mystery here. He's not sure that you like him, let alone how much you like him. But the goal here is that it's not blatantly obvious. He's not totally sure, but he does know that there may be something. That's the only thing that's really clear to him, but that's enough. That's what creates the challenge. That's what pushes him off balance in a fun way. And that's what you always want to do, because this is what creates the chemistry that you are looking for. Now, if you really cannot help it and you want to give him an actual compliment, then do it indirectly. Do it in a feminine way. Let's say that you are talking to a guy and it's clear that he's the type that works out a lot because he packs on a lot of muscle. So instead of saying, I see your workout, that's really sexy. You say something else. You say, I like that jacket that you are wearing. That's the type of jacket that can make a guy sexy if he works out. Can you see what this sentence is going to do? Now his mind goes, wait, what? What? So what's she now saying? Am I now sexy, or is she implying that other guys with this type of jacket are sexy? What? I'm not sure. She would only say this if I'm the sexy one, right? Now, steam may or may not be coming out of his ears because of all of that thinking, he's getting feelings. He's going to feel a desire to prove to you that he does have sexy muscles. He's going to want to find out what you meant exactly. He wants to decipher what just happened here. And he will be thinking about this very conversation and about you hours from now when he's at home, away from you. He will still be thinking about you. That evidently is something that you want as well. That's where chemistry and attraction are created. Can you sense how much more powerful this is than saying, "You look great and sexy"? You look great and sexy is what you say to the guy you've been with for 2 years, not for 2 dates. It's way too much too soon. So this here, what I've just explained, is how you show him in a sassy, strong, and self-confident way that you like him. And it's in such a way that it will, if he likes you too, make him go after you, make him ask you out, make him get to know you better, and eventually make you breakfast with freshly squeezed orange juice, if that's what you like, or at least a cup of coffee with your name spelled correctly on the cup. That's what you get when you give men a challenge. Start giving a challenge from the very first second until deep into the relationship. So there you go. I hope you found this interesting. If you want more stuff, come on over to brianknox.com. Click on the link in the description underneath this video here. If you want to read any of my books, you can find them on Amazon by going to the search engine on Amazon and by typing in my pen name, Brian Knox, and then you will see a list of all of the books I've got. I also want to take a second to thank everyone who's been sending me positive feedback. I love making videos and writing books for women like you. I find it really energizing when I see all of those stories of women that have been using the stuff I talk about and that are getting results with it. So thank you for that. If you need more, you will find a link in the description underneath this video. Thank you for watching this one, and I'll see you next time.